Learn VLLM with Sam. And today we are going to focus on this VLLM engine argument, which controls how many batch tokens it should include for each iteration. And this is a very powerful parameter that allows you to improve the aggregate performance of VLLM, which is continuous batching. And in this video, we are going to follow up on the previous video we did on getting Deepseek R1 8B working on a single L4 GPU. And this time we're going to add this parameter on top, and we're going to see what is the performance before with this not being set and using the default for it, and how much does the performance improve after we do add this. All right, so we have the same model as we used in the last video, where we increased the GPU memory utilization and the max model length. And this time we're going to test the performance without setting this. As you can see, it's coming out. So we're not going to set the maximum batch token just yet. And what we're going to do is we're going to run the benchmarking script of VLLM. And then we are going to see what is the performance without these parameters set. So let's give this a run. We're pointing it to the Cube AI endpoint that I port forwarded locally. And then we are going to, this takes a few minutes. We're going to wait for the results to come back. We're going to record them. Then we're going to enable the max numbatch tokens and see what is the performance afterwards. What this does is it sends 1,000 requests all at once to the VLLM server that's running. And then we'll wait for all these requests to complete. And then it's going to show us statistics like total token throughput, mean time of time to first token, etc. All right, the results are there, and let's take a look at them. We sent 1,000 successful requests and we got successful responses. The benchmark took 336 seconds, and then the total token throughput was 1260 tokens per second, which includes both the request and the output, the input tokens and the output tokens that were generated throughout this benchmark. Let's capture this number and let's put it in our as a note: without batched token, total token per sec was 1260. And what we're going to do now is we're going to enable this, and then we're going to rerun that same benchmark, and we're going to analyze how much does it improve or not improve performance. So let's uncomment it. And now we should just apply this. Okay, so let's apply the new mod manifest. I already did it once before. And then let's take a look at what's happening with the pod. It looks like it does not like the new flag. I think let's investigate what's going on. Oh, it seems like because we're enabling numbatch tokens, it now no longer fits in GPU memory with this sequence length. So it's telling us we have to decrease the max sequence lengths or increase the GPU memory utilization further. For now, I want to keep the bigger sequence lengths, but for now, let's just do an experiment where we decrease both the max sequence lengths and increase the numbatch tokens. So one more change that we're going to make. The new sequence length that we have to use is this. And then that is because the default maximum batch tokens is smaller, which means it requires less GPU memory to run because it doesn't need to allocate as much KV cache, is my understanding. Let's try this again. So we should make sure that we capture that with higher sequence. So it looks like that did the trick. So reducing the sequence length with changing max model length to something lower, but then being able to increase the maximum batch token, the hope is that this will improve the performance. Let's see if that's true. We are going to run the exact same benchmark with the same flags, and we set the seed parameter, so the same data set gets reused as well. And we're using a shared GPT data set, which mimics chat conversations with a large language model. All right, so we have the new results after enabling maximum batch tokens, and let's compare the performance. So I think the other one it took slightly more overall, but let's compare the total token throughput, which we had captured here. So we can see it's not that big of a change actually in this case. I think we can improve that further later, but let's for now just compare how much of a percentage change it is. So we have the new one. So it's roughly a 5% increase in total throughput that we're seeing in this for this specific benchmark. Roughly 5% improvement in total token throughput. All right, that was the main thing I wanted to show in this video tutorial, is like simply enabling this maximum batch tokens. In the next video, we'll learn how we can even increase the context lens further by using things like KV cares, lower bit formats like FP8 versus using 16-bit formats. Let me know in the comments if there's anything else you would like me to cover.